Now, let's just have a look at commutivity. Now, remember what I said, it's not part of the definition of groups, but you might find that in some groups, some elements or elements do commute. So let's just look at that. So that'll be a special kind of group. It's definitely not true for groups in general. So we have this statement. We're going to let AB equals BA for all AB elements of some group under multiplication, group G under multiplication. And we say, if this is true, show that the inverses of A and B also commute. So the proof for this actually would be just very easy. We are given, yes, we can write that, it's given the fact that AB equals BA. And what can we do? Well, let's start bringing things this way. So I can put a B inverse on that side. So B inverse, this is AB. So B inverse B, that's this E. And I have an A, I can bring A inverse this side. So I have A inverse B inverse AB. That equals E, because I put an A inverse there. Now let's take the B inverse to that side. So A inverse B inverse A equals, I've got a B inverse there, which makes this E. So I've got a B inverse on this side. Eventually at the end, I'll take an A inverse on both sides. So I have A inverse B inverse equals B inverse A inverse. So as simple as that. As simple as that. So if we do have this commutative property of commutivity for this very special group, then the inverses of these two will also commute. So in this instance, let's have a look. Same thing is holding here. I'm saying that there is, in this special group of mine G, this commutivity, just show that A, B, and A would commute. Well, it's given, it's definitely given that A, B equals B, A. And I can just put an A on both sides at the front. So A and AB equals A and BA. And all I have to do now, this is a group. So I do have this associativity. So I can say that these two and those two, and lo and behold, A and AB commute because I have A and AB equals AB and A. So that's an easy one. Still with this very special group of mine, let's just show that A squared and B would commute. So we're going to say given AB equals BA, I can put A in the front. So I'll have AB, AAB equals ABA. And we know that AB equals BA. So I can say A squared B equals B. A, associativity there, AB is BA, so I can swap those two around. So I have the fact that A squared B equals B, A squared, and they commute as well. So let's have a look at this one. Slightly more interesting, you need to now show that A squared and B squared commute. So given that AB equals BA, I can say that A squared BA equals ABA. It's putting an A in the front, let's put a B in the back. I have A squared B squared equals ABAB. Not exactly what I want, but we can do association. AB equals BA. So that is going to be BA with another A, A squared B. And we've just shown that B squared and A squared, that A squared and B squared commute. So those two commute, we've just shown that. So we're going to have that B squared A squared as I turn those two around. So I have A squared B squared equals B squared A squared. Okay, we've added another special one. We've added X there. So A, B, and X are element of this very special group. And I still have the property for this special group that we do have this commutivity. And I'm asked to do that. So given... You have to think about this one a bit. And of course, you've got to be slightly creative. Let's have AB, X inverse. And let's have that. And do exactly the same on this side. AB, X inverse. So I'm not using a special property here. What is there is exactly there. Nothing different. I do know, though, that AB X inverse, that equals X associativity BA X inverse. And now I can just bring in my identity, and I know that X X inverse equals the identity element because this is a group. And so let's just bring E in. I'm going to bring E in right there in this form. So I'm going to have X, it's not squared there, I don't know why I have that there. And anyway, X A, let's have X inverse X, which is this E, B X inverse, and that's going to be X, and I'm going to bring E in right there. So I'm going to have X, let's see, we're going to have X B X inverse X, A X inverse, and now I'm just going to use associativity, oops, there and there. So in other words, X A X inverse, that's one, and X B X inverse, that is going to be X B X inverse X A X inverse, and we see that they commute. So just a little bit of creativity, and you won't just get it the first time, except if they're quite easy, and of course if you're terribly smart. But sit around and play with them, and it doesn't take too long if you use a bit of creativity and you play around, and these are actually quite a bit of fun to do.